Oh, too much. Right there. So, exposure. Hey everyone, Camber here, back with you, and today we are talking about exposure. And if you're new here, this channel is all about teaching you how to use your camera to make good films. So if that's you, consider subscribing. Now, exposure is the amount of light allowed to hit the image sensor of your camera while taking a photo or a video. In the days of film cameras, there was an actual mechanism that was in front of the film. When taking a photo, the mechanism would move out of the way and allow light to hit the film for a period of time. Then the mechanism would move back in front of the film and block out the light once again. So you are literally exposing the film to light, hence the term exposure. And most digital photo cameras work in a similar way, like the DSLR. However, most smaller digital photo cameras and almost all video cameras don't have a physical mechanism in front of the sensor and instead use an electronic shutter. So both mechanical and electronic shutters work in a similar way. However, all you really need to know is that longer exposure times result in a brighter image and more motion blur, and shorter exposure times result in a darker image and less blur. And for a photo, you're dealing with one exposure, whereas for video, you're dealing with a constant stream of exposures, known as frame rate, that are anywhere from 24 to 60 frames per second for normal looking video, and above 60 frames per second for high speed video, typically used for slow motion. And exposure is controlled by three main things in your camera, and that is your aperture, your shutter speed, and your ISO. And each of these is going to get their own video in much greater detail in the future, but for a quick overview, your aperture controls how much light hits your camera sensor, your shutter speed controls how long the light hits your sensor, and your ISO will control the sensitivity of your sensor to light. And for stylistic effects, your aperture controls your depth of field or the blurriness of your background, your shutter speed will control the motion blur of your image, and the ISO is going to control how grainy your footage looks. So when your exposure is set properly, a change in any one of these settings will require an equivalent change in one or more of the other settings. And in order to be able to control all of these settings, you need to be shooting in manual mode. But how do you know if your exposure is set properly? Well, let's take a look at the exposure meter inside your camera. Looking at the meter scale, you should see a 0 in the middle with a 1 and 2 on each side of the 0. Each of the numbers on the meter scale represents a stop of light, which is a doubling or halving of the amount of light let in when taking a photo. So if you hear a person talk about increasing exposure by one stop, that simply means to capture twice as much light as on the previous shot, or half as much by decreasing a stop. Moving to the right side of the zero results in an overexposed image, and to the left results in an underexposed image. Now, there are different types of metering modes in your camera that will affect the way your camera senses light and displays it on your metering scale, and we'll cover this in a separate video. However, in general, if your scene is evenly lit, the zero on your metering scale should represent a properly exposed image. So the goal is to properly expose all of your shots. However, I prefer to be a little underexposed because as soon as you overexpose anything, especially skin, you can't get that information back. But on the flip side, if your footage is too underexposed, when you brighten it in editing, it'll start getting grainy very quickly. So getting exposure correct is crucial to your footage looking good. And that's all I have for exposure. So if you made it this far, hit that thumbs up and let me know down below if you have any more questions about exposure. Subscribe if you haven't, and remember that the only way to get better at something is to practice. So get out there and film something. See you soon.